skateboarding. I hate it.
Everybody's f***ing cool, you know.
And I'm f***ing part of it.
Stupid.
This show is about skating and talking to skaters about mental health. We did an episode on how pro skater Ben Raemers' tragic death sparked a mental health movement and decided we should let more people talk about the struggles in their minds. This film is about a Polish guy called Gonzi, a great skater and artist who has been vocal about his mental health and how he's managed to come back from the brink of schizophrenia.
I found skateboarding when I was about 5 or 6. Whenever I heard the noise of the wheels, I was like going to the window and just like checking, oh, those guys cool, I wanna try it.
Gonzi got picked by older skaters quite quickly because of the energy he had.
He stood out, he immediately had his own style. He resembled a Colombian skater, David Gonzalez, and that's why his nickname is Gonzi.
I think art and painting is a big part of Gonzi's escape from his darker moments.
I smoked my first joint when I was 13 or 14. And after that, it was more about getting wasted than going out skating. I didn't know that I'm in the process of preparing myself for a mental breakdown. Łódź is my hometown. There's plenty of homeless people, mostly people describing the city as gray and ugly. It's a like a Polish Detroit or something.
Hey, Gonzi, dawaj już tam ten.
Dobra, heel flip i frontside smith.
I don't describe myself as a good skateboarder, but I think I do have an intuition for an interaction with the spot. And that's my way of skating.
He likes to find the spots in those corners of our city where, you know, other skaters never skate. I really fell in love with our city because of skating and filming with Gonzi.
Brawe, coś innego na placu.
Nie, no daj mi z tego heela. Będzie fajna sekwa. Ze śmiesznym heelem.
Tak, ale jeszcze nie dojechałeś do murka ani razu.
No dobra, ale smith to już jest, wiesz, jest chill. Zaraz mnie wkurwi to, no. Kurwa, no jestem blisko, stary, tylko jebany heel flip. Kurwa, kurwa, no kurwa!
This is how much heart he puts into skating, and when I see that tree doesn't work, I'm gonna change it. And he will just go deeper and deeper into this. So he will just act spontaneously, get angry, break the board, and then, you know, walk home to get another board because he doesn't really feel about consequences at, you know, at the moment. That's how he is, I guess.
I think the pressure comes from the internet. I hate it, man, because you're like observing those rippers, but real life not looks like that.
Się było tutaj.
Najlepszy chyba nie lepszy tutaj.
Tak?
Ale jestem mokry.
Yes, man. I think Gonzi is really famous for breaking boards and being mad at a skateboard, and I love it. I would rather see him do this than drink, smoke, get in the fights. Breaking a board doesn't hurt anyone. He just lets this tension to just, you know, break while we are skateboarding. I think Gonzi was the first person that really approached me with depression. He started to share his dark sides and those thoughts that are going through his head.
Trudno było sobie gdzieś przełożyć na to, że on ma jakiś problem, skoro jest takim wesołym gościem. Była sytuacja u nas w domu. Po kilku jointach, po kilku piwkach nagle zaczął jakiś monolog. Zaczął go powtarzać, wręcz krzyczeć, płakać. No i gdzieś wyszli ze swoją dziewczyną.
Kiedy rano się obudziliśmy i on dalej spał, pamiętam, że siedziałam na kanapie i myślałam sobie, co my z tym kurwa zrobimy? Czułam, że nie mam narzędzi do tego, żeby się tym zająć.
So that's the studio I'm on. Basically, I paint, but I like to just experimenting with the materials. Art, of course, is a form of therapy, but works really similar to skateboarding because you can express yourself through the tool. I cannot imagine how the person can function without expression. It's like a bottom of my existence, I guess. That's my newest experiment. I'm basically doing everything from the bottom, constructing all of it. The most beautiful thing about art is just like pure freedom. Maybe I'm naive, but I've experienced a lot of bad shit, so I do have like a, background.
It's just a studio, it's an ordinary basement, so fireworks are in that room.
Lino cut. That's my dad's general technique. That's the OG of the technique.
So?
That's the OG of the technique.
This OG.
Original gangster. I discovered it's totally not my aesthetic, but still my roots are located somewhere in that area. Imagine you're a goddamn 4 years old kid and that's one of your first images.
Why didn't I paint pink princesses and unicorns and flowers and clouds?
Yeah, I guess my life would be much easier.
Mm-hmm. Oh, it's all my fault, my son.
You f***ed it all up, pop.
These are incredible drawings. I think he was maybe 7, maybe 8. Oh. He was 5 then.
Tomek zawsze był bardzo pogodny. Ile ma zdjęć, na wszystkich jest zadowolony.
Because he was smiling from morning till night. He was a wonderful kid.
I had a beautiful childhood. I was always like this kind of a kid who was exploring and open for everything. I was always next to my dad and next to my grandpa and just like spending the time with them. Then I found skateboarding and that involved me totally. Since I've touched the skateboarding, I was always hanging out with older guys. It was naturally to just like start doing stuff what older guys do. I think I've smoked my first joint when I was 13 or 14. New doors open. I think the breaking point was when I was 15 and my grandpa passed away. And after that, I've been so smashed that I started doing it more.
When we were chatting when we were kids, he was telling me those stories from the parties with the older skaters that I really found like surreal for my age back then.
It was more about getting wasted than going out skating. I just like didn't know that I'm in the process of like preparing myself for a mental breakdown. It was about 7 or 8 years ago when I was 17. I was hanging out with my school buddies. We smoked some joint. We ate some crystal. We were having beers. And suddenly something clicked. I had permanent deja vu effect. And I just like was like, watching my colleagues. My heart started beating stronger and stronger. That was f***ing crazy, man. We went back home. After 2 or 3 days, flashback just came. And it kept me for a few months. One morning, I went to school, but I felt so bad, the ambulance took me from the school, and I found myself in a psychiatric hospital.
Otrzymaliśmy ten telefon ze szkoły, że pogotowie go zabiera, bo on jest w stanie takim demencji.
Będąc w szpitalu, zobaczył, do jakiego stanu się ludzie doprowadzają.
To był oddział zamknięty. I tam nie wolno było wchodzić nikomu, rodzicom nie wolno było wchodzić.
To był dla nas szok, ale staraliśmy się być razem w tym wszystkim, żeby nie odtrącać go.
I've been in a psychiatric hospital for like a month or something. They detoxed me, they gave me medicines, and they told me that I'm one step before schizophrenia.
Moje pierwsze wrażenia dotyczące stanu psychicznego Tomka dotyczyły poważnego, postępującego i takiego nasilającego się odrealnienia. Trochę schizotypowego, powiedzmy, zaburzenia. Według mnie największym zagrożeniem wówczas, gdy to trafił, była groźba zachorowania na schizofrenię paranoidalną, co zresztą pozostaje aktualne do dzisiaj.
Miał taki okres wątpliwości we własne siły. No. Koleżanka zabrała go w góry. Tam siedzieli tydzień czasu, w odosobnieniu zupełnie. To była 18 lat starsza koleżanka, Agnieszka.
Bałam się, że on sobie zrobi krzywdę. Ja też rok wcześniej przeżyłam stratę kogoś bliskiego ze środowiska deskorolkowego i nie chciałam, żeby ktoś kolejny zniknął z tego świata po prostu.
During that time I had a lot of suicide thoughts.
To był chyba taki moment graniczny, kiedy ja zdałam sobie sprawę z tego, że jemu trzeba po prostu pomóc. Że jeżeli ja mu nie pomogę, to nie wiem, czy ktoś mu pomoże.
After a bit of time, I shared similar things with Paweł, but she was like the first person. She acted like a second mother. She was so close to me. And after that, I just felt, okay, she saved my life.
Walczyłam o to, żeby Tomek przetrwał.
Dałaś radę?
No tak.
Płakałaś?
Płakałam.
After that, I isolated from the party buddies, and now I cared about the relations with the closest people I've still got. I'm really thankful for the medicines. I'm really thankful for my passions, and of course, number one, I'm really thankful for all those guys that are next to me.
Spotykają się, to wszyscy się ściskają i czuję się taką więź między nimi.
I guess maybe my story show how important it is to talk. Everything can be figured out. It's not a end of the life. Be direct.
I think the most important part of getting treatment with any mental illness, if it's depression or, you know, schizophrenia or anything, is just not to be alone. And that's what we wanted to, you know, make sure that he gets.
Uzależnienie chyba nadal stanowi poważne zagrożenie dla realizacji jego talentu.
I think Gonzi definitely should stay away from any psychoactive drugs.
And I totally understand that it's not for me, because I don't want to have a schizophrenia.
Nie martwię się o niego. Stoi dalej na nogach mocno, ale nie wojuje z rzeczywistością, tylko stara się z nią gadać.
It's crazy how people mind their own business. And I think it's important to remember that there's just few of them that actually mind your business too.